Here's Jake Oettinger game breakdown, his most recent game against the Devils. A couple of you asked for him to be reviewed, and I thought, you know, he's one of the best goalies in the NHL, both statistically and subjectively. He's 6'5", giant goalie. He skates like he's 5'11". He's got incredible composure and game reads. Just a real pro of kind of the modern era of goaltending right now. So that's a great save there. A lot of times, you know, when we drop into our VH, it's very easy to get stagnant. It's very easy to just block the puck. But look what he does with his blocker, how he stays reactive and he puts the puck kind of out to the side as opposed to popping it right in front of him. Little funny bounce there, kind of loses it behind the net, but managed to hold his post and stay on it. Good stop. Let's see that again here. So the clip doesn't, oh yeah, so it's a turnover in the zone. Beats the pass on his feet. We always want to do that if we can. He's deep in the net here and he takes like a little shuffle. Low pad save. Keeping his eyes on it through traffic. Good stop. Ah, tough one. So Jack Hughes, one of the better players in the NHL, comes down here and just beats him 5-0. Tough situation. I'm sure he would like to have that one back. You know, it's obviously a breakaway stop. It's obviously a breakaway, but, you know, anytime we can eliminate a goal going through us or under us, we want to. So another quick play here. A big thing with this is, for me, it looks like he was still moving when this shot was taken. I believe that's Riley Woods. Played against him in college. He's got an amazing shot. So whenever we're not set, it becomes so much tougher to track these pucks just because our feet, our hands, everything is moving, right? And when we're moving, we're not in control and we're not able to focus on the puck as much. So see how he's sliding to the right? I'm sure if you asked him, he would love to be set on that play. Easy stop, good glove. And when I do some of these game breakdowns, this is, again, not a shot at any of these goalies because, you know, most of the guys I'm reviewing are in the NHL and 10 times the goalie that I am. But it's just things that I noticed that I'm sure they would like to work on. So that's an amazing save there. Now you notice the difference in this save because he sets his feet. His feet are set here. He's ready for the shot. And he gets a little, through a screen, gets a little bit of drift, hits him high in the glove there. So a big difference for me in that save and the goal that he let in on that kind of 2-on-1, 3-on-2 is setting his feet. Good stop. Now, this is the difference between being 6'5 and even being like 6'1, 6 feet. He's able to drop into a reverse right now and seal this top corner. When the puck's at this angle, you're not gonna be able to hit this top corner, you know? This is the area just because of the different angles, right? So he's able to fully cover the net in this position. He's 6'5", he's an NHL goalie, one of the premier goalies. He knows how his game is. For most of us, I wouldn't recommend dropping into this RVH here because I think we're going to be, you know, probably a lot shorter and give up way more room. So that just speaks to the importance of knowing your game, right? Good stop. Look at that push too. This is a super, super powerful slide. He gets over there quickly. And like I was saying, you know, he's 6'5". He's a big goalie, but he moves well. He moves very well. Good stop. Another little thing here. This is, again, he's a big goalie, but look how quickly and how much net, look how quickly he moves to the top of his crease on a pass up to the point. Maybe even gets a little bit off the top of the crease there. So look where he makes that save at. He's 6'5", and he's 6'5", and he's still moving to the top of the crease here. I know a lot of us think, well, maybe I can get away with playing a little deeper and staying in the net. And there's definitely times and place for that, and I advocate for it for some times. But personally, I think any time we can get to that top of the crease, especially on like low to high plays, I think we really want to. Low to high plays up to the point, I should say. Not maybe a low high play where the guy's in the middle of the slot. Again, he's fighting for sight lines. He's competing. Look where he is when he makes this save. He's moving into it at the top of the crease. You know, he's not just staying back in his blue paint and letting New Jersey tip pucks on him. Great job. So great use of the stick there. Kicks a would-be rebound up into the glass out of, out of immediate threat area. Again, good stop, good save off the 1T, off the face-off. Catches it, no rebound. Great save. Look at how he stays compact. He stays poised, moves into the stick blade to where the puck is going, not to the player's body. Great stop. Great stop. Tough one-timer save. Staying active with his hands, which is what I like too. So again, this is something that I've been talking to some of you about and, you know, trying to incorporate in my game. There's one New Jersey player on the ice. Now, he's way off the side even when he shoots this puck. Like, this is not a scoring threat per se, but I still want you to look where Ottis is in the net. He's 6'5". He's outside the blue because he knows this is the only person, the only guy he has to worry about, right? So I think this just kind of speaks to his goalie IQ and understanding that this is primary target. This is the only target. I need to be above the paint. I need to save this. You know, I think it's easy for some of us to get caught being in the blue here, thinking about, oh, well, what about this? What about this rebound? Or what about this guy coming back? You know, if we can't see it, there's no one in the picture. We need to stop the shot 100% of the time, pretty much. That's what kind of modern goaltending is all about. 100%, 99% of the time, right? That's the level of professionalism or the level of, you know, criticism, I guess, that a position gets, right? Again, great stop. Oh, brutal. That's tough. So, great position there. Puck just tips off his own defenseman's stick and goes in. You know, you're going to have those goals every now and then, right? Sometimes we can do all we can, but it's going to hit someone's stick, hit someone's shin pad, and we're unable to react. So that was a breakdown of Ott's. That's, you know, he's showing why he's one of the best goalies in the NHL. His skating, his poise, his goalie IQ is just elite. Thanks, guys. Thanks so much for watching. You know, shoot me a message, shoot me an email if you want me to go over a different goalie. Thank you so much.